Xin chào VN Express. Hello, my name is Ronnie del Carmen. I'm the co-director of Inside Out. Please come and watch our movie. I think that you will have an emotional and fun time.
Could you tell us your feeling when you watched Inside Out for the first time on big screen?
Well, the first time that I saw the movie finished with an audience, it was overwhelming. I was very happy because I hear the audience respond to our movie. They understand what Joy is doing, and then they also know how Joy is feeling or how Riley's feeling. And some of them, when they watch it, I can see their hands. After a certain moment, they go up and they go and
cry.
Something.
How hard it is to be a co-director with Pete Doctor for 5 years.
Actually, making a movie for 5 years is very hard. It could be any movie that you make. If you make something that takes that long to make, it's very difficult. Making a movie with Pete Doctor, I'm the luckiest person I know, because Pete is very collaborative, and not only that, he is a lot of fun to work with. There are challenges that we have to face when we're working together. There's a lot of things that any two human beings will have differences, but I'm lucky because I don't have a lot, actually, of difference with Pete. We actually have a lot of things in common. It's been a great trip, and I'm very grateful for the shot.
In your opinion, what makes the difference between Inside Out and other Pixar films?
Well, the big difference is that it's a movie about emotions. All the other characters that we've created somehow are kind of physically present in the world our characters share, but Inside Out happens inside the mind world. None of them it's an unusual and very unique world. We've never done anything like this before. As characters too, the most unique feature of Inside Out is that the characters inside Riley's head know about Riley, but Riley don't know about those characters inside her head. They never meet. They don't have conversations.
Being a famous Asian filmmaker in Hollywood, do you have any advice for the young animation filmmaker who wants to work for Pixar?
Well, I think that the better goal is to be a good storyteller. Because I think that it's good to kind of say that one day I would love to work for Disney or Pixar. It's a good goal, but you don't want that to be the one mark that says that you've succeeded. What you should aspire for is to be a good storyteller. It'll bring you to so many different journeys that may be even better than going to one studio or that studio. The one advice I actually tell people when it comes to wanting to become a storyteller or a filmmaker is that you should tell stories that you care about, and then you should finish them and then show it to people. Because it's better for you to actually make something that people can comment on so that you can get better as you go. Most people would probably have projects that they want to make, but they don't finish them. And sometimes they actually make something that they finish, but they don't show it to people. They think that it's already good. Yeah. Well, what you should do is actually just to get better each time. You make it, you finish it, and then you show it to people and start over. Or make something new and do it over and over and over again. Maybe you're not good at this, you're not good at that. You'll get better at those things. People give you comments of what you can fix about your stories or the way that you tell stories. Pay attention and you'll get better at that. The more times that you can try, the better you get.
Ngay từ khoảnh khắc đầu tiên khi cô bé vừa mở mắt, tôi cũng ở đó. Tôi là Dui. Thật tuyệt, làm sao? Ồ, được có 30 giây à?
Mình là bồ.
Chào cậu.
Những giọng nói nhỏ trong đầu
có
bạn.
Nguy hiểm ở đây. Đó là chảnh. Cô ấy giữ cho Riley khỏi bị đầu độc. Là một cái xinh hảo ăn.
Nhưng phải mời ông ăn trước.
Đó là nóng nảy. Và đó là sợ. Cậu ấy giỏi giữ cho Riley an toàn.
Cảm ơn.
Đây là ký ức của Riley. Các bạn sẽ thấy đa số là vui. Chuyện gì vậy? Buồn hả?
Cậu ấy đã làm gì đó với quả cậu?
Mọi việc ổn chứ con?
À, con không biết.
Đó là đi vui.
Vui. Đi thôi.
Cắt yên lỗi.
Không.
Mùa hè này
nó không hoạt động. Sao nó không hoạt động?
Mọi chuyện nghiêm trọng rồi đây.
Ước gì vui ở đây?
Mình ở đâu đây?
Đó là ký ức dài hả?
Mình sửa được mà. Mình chỉ cần quay về cơ quan đầu não.
Cứ dừng bị lạc đó.
Lạc quan lên đi.
Mình lạc quan là cậu sẽ bị lạc trong đó.
Từ những nhà sáng tạo ra
Vùng Đất Mộng Mơ, hãng phim giấc mơ, chỗ này lớn ghê.
Khám phá những cảm xúc.
Lại đây, ôm nào.
Từ sâu trong tâm trí.
Đóng men.
Bám chắc nha.
Những mảnh ghép cảm xúc, một bức tranh cảm xúc đa sắc. CJCCB hân hạnh phát hành tháng 8 2015 với định dạng 2D và 3D, phiên bản lồng tiếng và phụ đề.